Hi everyone, Nick here. And have you seen these carousel posts all over social media? LinkedIn especially has some really great examples of creators posting these carousels, these really fun, snackable, swipeable lists that are full of valuable tips, tricks, and resources. So I decided to make a carousel on 9 tips on how to make a carousel in PowerPoint. And so I just wanted to walk you through some of the features here. So I just love the fact that you can use PowerPoint to make carousels just like this. We set the slide dimensions to a square size, and you can see that when we click over, I'm gonna click right here, it'll swipe over, and I love the fact that this image can span 2 different slides, and we can make this in PowerPoint. I'm gonna show you how right after this. But you can just swipe right through, you can add some information here, you can see I have the really dark number in the background, which is really nice. It's not just sort of a 1, 2, 3, it's kind of there in the background. We have a really vibrant background image that's set to some transparency fill to make it really fade into the background. And then any carousel is not complete unless you provide a call to action at the very end of that carousel. And I just wanted to share with you that I'm gonna put this up as a $10 download on my Gumroad souvenir shop for a template. And I kind of made this into a carousel template that you can use and customize on your own. So grab that link in the comments below. But I'm gonna show you a couple little tricks here on how I worked that first. I'm gonna go back to that first image. I'm gonna give you a little bit of insight as to how I work with that image so that we can get it to span across 2 different slides just like this, and it looks pretty seamless when you just go back and forth like that. Pretty cool. Okay, I'm gonna escape out of here. Let's go up to our example slides here. I have the photo. I downloaded this photo from the stock images in PowerPoint, and you can do that by going to the insert tab and then the pictures and then stock images here. There, once you click on it, you can search for any photo that you want. I wanna make this photo nice and large. I'm gonna hold down the shift key and drag it up so that it's pretty big. When you hold down the shift key, that makes sure that everything stays proportional. So when you resize photos like that by sort of clicking and dragging, make sure to hold down the shift key and then drag the corner so that everything stays proportional. We don't want our pictures to be stretched up or down. The first thing I want to do is actually I want to remove the background because I don't want this background here anymore. We can do that right in PowerPoint by going to the picture format tab and then click on remove background. It'll automatically give you sort of a best guess, and then you have to kind of click around so you can see the hands aren't in the photo and some of the hair and then some of the body. So we're going to go down here and say mark areas to keep, or up here to say mark areas to keep, and then I'm just going to kind of click around right here and see how it goes. Just click around. And sometimes things go a little bit haywire, but it's not too bad. PowerPoint's getting better and better at this, I think, every single day. That looks pretty good. So once you're done, you're gonna say keep changes, and now you have this beautiful photo with no background. It's a great way to sort of make your focal image, your person or object, really sort of stand out. Okay. So now I made it a little bit smaller. So now what we want to do in this, in order to make it span across the slide, is I'm going to duplicate the photo. We're just going to duplicate it like this. Control D. So they're right on top of each other. And each of the photos is going to be cropped in half, but with the right or left side showing. So right here on top, I'm going to click on this photo, go to picture format, click on crop, and then this is going to be the photo that I use here. I'm not even gonna do it halfway. I'm just gonna do it like this. We're gonna click OK. So that's gonna be our cropped image. And now with the photo in the back, I'm gonna click on this. And it already gives us, you can see this is the cut point right here. So that's the cut point that we need there. So I'm gonna crop that and say OK. So now we have these 2 images here. I'm gonna place this onto the right. And if we wanted to, we could just align this directly to the right of the slide with our arrange tools. Perfect. And now I'm going to cut this from the first slide. We're going to paste it onto the second side. Control V. And we'll put that right there. We could also just align it to the left. This is so awesome. So now, when we put this in slideshow mode, we'll click over. It looks like we have a perfect match there. And now if you want to do some extra engagement in PowerPoint here, I just added the push transition. So highlight the two slides that you want to add that sort of swiping action transition, go to the transition tab, and then click on push. And now it defaults to this up and down, but we're going to go over here to the effect options, and I'm going to say from the right. And now it gives me a nice little preview there. And it pushes. Perfect. That's just like a swipeable carousel. Pretty awesome. Now you see in my original one, I had a little bit of some other graphics. So I had this PowerPoint logo here, and I just put that there to kind of, you know, have, we're going to move this to the front, just kind of look like she's holding it. And then I just added this little grouped line. I just added four separate lines and then kind of grouped them and arranged them in a way to kind of give it some action there. But you can definitely do that. Make sure to put your website at the top, a nice big chunky title. I'm using Fira Sans for my font up here. Make sure to use something nice and thick. Don't necessarily use the default, which is Calibri, but pretty cool carousel. So if you want this carousel template, you'll get all of these slides that I have right here, and then also just a basic template slide, so you can insert an image that will fill the background of the slide, and then two text boxes right here. You can just insert those new slide layouts every time you want to do that, and you can customize it on your own. So again, it's just a quick $10 download. It really helps out with my production of these videos. I appreciate all the downloads from my Gumroad souvenir shop. I hope you like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up and make sure to click the subscribe button and then click the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this video for you, and I hope you all have a great day.